Now that you're awake, let me show you everything you've missed while you were sleeping. Mic check.
Feels good. Come on!
Yeah, baby. Welcome to Connecting the Purple Dots.
Every hole you open and close, I've told you that before. Mm-hmm. They're listening. Every hole you open up is closing now.
I've just started following Dots, connected to Purple Dots. He's very well researched. I like him a lot.
As many of you know, Thursday morning, I woke up, looked at my phone, and saw a notification from Twitter. It was a tweet, or should I say retweet, by Lundell McMillan. And it stated, "Imagine what we'll all be like in our own game." And there was a picture of Chuck D, and of course the link to the video from Prince's 2000 Artist of the Decade Award. And so at first glance, I thought to myself, oh, that's cool. But then I played the video and I realized exactly what was being pointed out to me. That as you can see here, Mr. Chuck D introduced Prince, and then Prince, along with Lundell McMillan escorting him onto the stage, walked out to thunderous applause. Once again, Prince uses his time to address the ills of the industry and to help artists of the future. Now, it struck me odd that for the first time after seeing this, now what we call the golden parachute speech, it's the first time that I recognized Lundell McMillan was standing next to Prince as he escorted him onto the stage and began addressing the crowd with the now golden parachute speech. In my mind and my intuition tells me, nah, he's been there the whole time.
Take a minority share of the winnings. A select few of us will do well, the majority will not. So as a people, we'll be considered a minority. But stop. Let's take a moment and look at yourselves. There's nothing minor about you. You are a blessed people. You're the most talented on earth, and you are still grateful. That is why upon winning in their game, you always thank God. Tonight I would like to ask one favor of you. Imagine what we'll all be like in our own game. Peace and love for one another.
See, word is in these purple streets that Lundell McMillan was fired by Prince and escorted out of Paisley Park. But keep in mind, Lundell McMillan had dual roles. He was not only Prince's attorney, but he was also Prince's manager. Hold on to that for now. In a response from Lundell McMillan, he tweets, "Excuse me, this is internationally false. I was never, ever fired by Prince. I say again, I was never, ever, ever fired by Prince. And even if I was, which I was not, so what? I lasted three times as long as any other manager or lawyer. Please make your name known and be truthful. Our achievements together are legendary." Do you see this part? I lasted three times as long as any other manager or lawyer. Those are two different things. Again, keep this in mind. As I would imagine, any kind of differences between Prince and Lundell McMillan, any kind of differences at all between two educated thinking men, would have gone something like this.
Look, I have to put my own interests above yours. It's nothing personal. You're fired.
Wait, so you're worried that if I stay, then they might find out that you lied about me and you'll lose your license. But if you fire me, then I could tell them that you lied about me and you definitely lose your license.
Are you telling me that if I throw you under the bus, you're going to drag me with you?
You put your interests above mine and I'm just putting mine back up next to yours.
You're rehired.
Let's keep in mind, in 1996, while Lundell McMillan was still an associate attorney, he was hired by Prince to free the musician from a multi-year contract with Warner Brothers. On March 4th, 2000, we see Lundell McMillan escort Prince on stage to receive the Artist of the Decade Award and stand next to him as he begins to make the now legendary Golden Parachute speech.
Somebody say Golden Parachute.
In 2007, Lundell McMillan would return back to the law firm that hired him directly after graduating from New York University School of Law. He would take with him his clients, including both Prince and Michael Jackson. In 2008, Lundell McMillan would make the 50 most influential minority lawyers in America by representing both Michael Jackson and Prince, along with several other celebrity clients. Now let's discuss dual roles. For Lundell McMillan, we've known that he was Prince's manager and attorney. As stated previously, those are two different things. Just like in any corporation, there is a CEO and chairman of the board. Those are two different roles. You see, you can be CEO and chairman of the board, but at some point in time, often, the board collectively will vote and remove the CEO and bring in someone new. However, the previous CEO can remain as a board member or chairman of the board, but lose his CEO position and duties. Is it beyond reasonable doubt that perhaps because we've seen Prince's change in staff members and we've seen people come and go over the years, could it be at a specific point in time that Lundell McMillan simply just had a reduction in roles? Not fired, but a reduction in his role. Meaning, he no longer represented Prince as Prince's manager, but he stayed on as Prince's attorney in some capacity. Because we all know, you don't need an attorney every day. And just like Kirk Johnson stated, he didn't see Prince every day. It was only when what? Prince needed him. Same applies to your attorney. You only really talk to your attorney when you need your attorney. So, with that, if you have an attorney on retainer, again, you don't speak to him every day. You only have him there when you're needing of his abilities in the legal framework of things. So, when Lundell McMullen explains that Prince never ever fired him, perhaps this is what he is meaning. Because attorneys have no problem accepting being fired, especially when it's mutual. If both parties are not serving each other's needs, then they go their separate way. However, with Lundell McMullen stating Prince has never ever fired him, my intuition as well as my business sense tells me that Lundell McMullen never got fired. He perhaps just had a reduction in his role when it came to Prince. He went from being Prince's manager and lawyer to just being Prince's attorney. And the question I've asked is, we've seen Lundell McMullen over all of this time, regardless of what the word in the purple streets is, because we have no one who can really corroborate this information. We just have the word in the street. What we have is a tweet from Lundell McMullen stating he was never ever fired by Prince, which should tell you and me that Lundell McMullen is still working for Prince to this very day. Now, as I mentioned last week in the community tab, there is a big difference between copyright and trademarks. Keep in mind, copyright, as defined, is the exclusive legal right given to an originator or an assignee to print, publish, perform, film, or record literary, artistic, or musical material, and to authorize others to do the same. While trademarks are defined as a symbol, word, or words legally registered or established by use as representing a company or a product. So it was put out in the purple streets that Lundell McMullen had snatched up someone's merchandise. Being that Lundell McMullen is the managing member of the LLC that owns the expectancy interest of the Prince Rogers Nelson estate, he is well within his rights to snatch up, take, remove from anyone's possession something, product, merchandise, etc., that has been copywritten by Prince for Prince or trademarked by Prince for Prince. And if a state does not handle those particular disputes, they are definitely handled at the federal level. So he's well within his rights to do that, being Prince's never ever fired attorney.
I have my money, I want my tape, and I want it now. I want my tape, off this thing. Can't sell my stuff. I want that to be my shit. Take the money out of my pocket, money. Now I want my shit. I want my tape now. Or I'm gonna fuck your whole stand up. You understand what I'm saying? You don't understand? That's my tape. That's me. That's my group. Now, you take your money from me. You're selling my tape, but you got to pay me for my records. You understand that? Now, you got to take my tape down. Now, if you don't take my tape down immediately, I'm going to take your tape down.
objective at the same time.
How would you like that? On the floor. Like, you know what I'm saying?
What are you talking about?
Because you're not taking it back. You still talking. You should take my shit down.
Hey, take the tape
off. Come on,
man.
I'm serious.
Hey, take the tape off.
You have police to take this out, but not.
I have the right to do it.
But you take it to police.
No, I don't have to take it to the police.
You
can take it to the police. I'll drop the shit down.
Don't drop this shit. Don't drop this shit.
You got my tape. Shit. I throw your watch. He's selling my tape. He's stealing from me. You understand? That's me, man. I ain't gonna take it. You didn't get paid. You get paid on my sweat. You can't say shit. Mind your business. You mind your business. You don't have nothing to do with it. They got shit to do with it. Pay attention. Fix your watch, man. You understand? If I see my tape over here again, by the word of God, I swear I'm dropping your shit to the concrete. That's mine. You're robbing. I'm not playing. I'm going to watch a movie.
When I finish, I'm coming back. If my shit is out here, I'm dropping it. And if he says something, I'm dropping his watch. I'm serious. Fuck around.
Yeah, you want to play it this way? Fine. But if you think you can outsmart me, you're going to get lit up.
Lit the hell up.
Tell you what. Every hole you open and close, I've told you that before. Mm-hmm. They're listening. Every hole you open up is closing.
I've just started following dots, connect the purple dots, and he's very well researched. I like him a lot.